CIET NCERT presents curriculum based series Dhwani Shala. So let's join in Dhwani Shala class 7.
Hello children, how are you doing? Hope you are doing well, enjoying your lessons on the radio. Today I am going to take up a poem with you. This poem is from NCERT's English textbook for class 7, Honeycomb, and unit is 2. Before I tell you the name of the poem, I want to ask you a few questions. Okay? Shall I ask you? My first question is, do you know anyone? Anyone? Your friend, okay, your class fellow or your cousin who always disagrees with you or your friends? Do you know somebody who always disagrees with you? Like all of you are playing a game, maybe football or cricket, and you ask your friend to join you, and your friend says that I want to read a book. Yes, he has disagreed with you. Now all of you are busy reading. You are studying hard. This is your study time now. But your friend says, I am getting bored. I want to play. So do you know somebody? I am sure you know somebody. All of us do like that. It happens with all of us. It must have happened with you. Suppose your mother tells you to have your breakfast. You tell her, I will have it after some time. I am reading a book or I am watching TV. Do you ever do that? So you are not agreeing to what is being told to do. And there can be another situation. You are playing outside and you are being told that now it is your study time. But you say, no, I want to play. So you are disagreeing. We all do it sometimes or the other. We do the opposite of what is being told to us. Now think of a word to describe such a person. Think of a word. You may think of a word in your language. Write it down in your notebook. And then I will give you the English word. Have you written down the word in your own language? The language that you speak at home or the language that you know? Maybe we can call that person a rebel. The title of the poem is also The Rebel. The poet has described situations like that. Now, you are sitting together with your friend. You can discuss some things that you do exactly opposite from your friend. He is writing with a pencil. You want to write with a pen. And note down other things. Opposites. Are you writing down opposites now? Because in this poem, you will find that the poet has used opposites to create that image in front of our eyes. Now, well, if we look for the meaning of this word rebel in the dictionary, there are 2-3 meanings listed over there. But we have to look for the meaning as per our context. So our context is like a classroom situation or our friends together or cousins together. So in our context, in the context of the poem, it means a person who does not obey rules or does not do what others do. So the meaning of rebel is this: a person does exactly opposite to what others are doing. And as we have already discussed, that knowingly or unknowingly, we end up doing such a thing. Not always, but sometimes. Now, can you identify a friend or a person in the family who does this always? If you tell that person to go and have a bath, that person will say, no, not now. Right now I'm sleeping. If it is bedtime, you tell that person, now go to bed. The person says, it's time for me to read. So do you know any person like that? Write down the name of that person. We can use the word rebel in a sentence also. I have always been the rebel of the family, that I don't listen. Are you like that? I hope not. I think we should listen to what is being told to us. Discipline is a good value. Now I will read the poem for you. Please open your textbooks, page 33. And as you know, that poems are meant to be read aloud. Why? Because when we are reading aloud with proper tone, intonation, stress or pitch, then we get the meaning. Words convey meaning. I will read the poem. Pay attention. When everybody has short hair, the rebel lets his hair grow long. When everybody has short hair, the rebel wants to have long hair. When everybody has long hair, the rebel cuts his hair short. When everybody talks during the lesson, the rebel doesn't say a word. That means when you are having a discussion in the classroom, the teacher has asked you something, you are sharing your experiences, the rebel doesn't say anything. He's quiet. When everybody talks during the lesson, the rebel doesn't say a word. When nobody talks during the lesson, the rebel creates a disturbance. When everybody wears a uniform, the rebel dresses in fantastic clothes. That means he's wearing very formal clothes. When everybody wears fantastic clothes, the rebel dresses soberly. He wears simple clothes. In the company of dog lovers, the rebel expresses his preferences for cats. Now, dog lovers, people who keep dogs as pets, are talking about their pets, how they take care of the dog, how they, take them for a walk, etc. The rebel expresses preference for a cat. In the company of cat lovers, the rebel puts in a good word for dogs. Again, opposite. Here, he or she is in the company of cat lovers, people who keep cats as pets. The rebel is now talking about dogs. When everybody is praising the sun, the rebel remarks on the need for rain. If it's bright, sunlight, day, and the rebel says, no, there should be rain. When everybody is greeting the rain, after the summer season, we always greet the rain. The rebel regrets the absence of sun. Again opposing. When everybody goes to the meeting, the rebel stays at home and reads a book. Goes for a meeting, that means there is some work. Or you can say that everybody goes to school. Rebel wants to stay at home and read a book. When everybody stays at home and reads a book, the rebel goes to the meeting. When everybody says, yes, please, the rebel says, no, thank you. When everybody says, no, thank you, the rebel says, yes, please. It is very good that we have rebels. You may not find it very good to be one. I read the last two lines once again for you. It is very good that we have rebels. You may not find it very good to be one. We will discuss about these two lines in detail. But first, let us look at the poem now. Did you enjoy listening to the poem? Were you able to observe the contrast that the poet was bringing out? Just by bringing the opposites, he has given us the definition of a rebel. This poem is written by D.J. Enright. He has written many poems. He is a writer. And he's written poems for children. He also writes stories. Now, look at your poem once again and underline the opposites. Underline the opposites? Have you underlined the opposites? Yes, you must have. I am going to do a little activity with you right now. Your books are there in front of you. Page 33, 34. Right. I am going to read a few sentences which are not the exact sentences from the poem. When I read the sentence, you look for the exact sentence. The first one, the rebel refuses to cut his hair. Yes, you can find it on page 33. The rebel refuses to cut his hair. The exact line from the poem is, the rebel lets his hair grow long. He refuses to cut his hair. So that means the exact line is, the rebel lets his hair grow long. Is it clear to you? The next one. He says cats are better. Find out the exact sentence on page 33. Yes, you have been able to find. The sentence is, the rebel expresses a preference for cats. He expresses a preference for cats. My next sentence. He recommends dogs. Again on page 33, the last line. He puts in a good word for dogs. He puts in a good word for dogs. I have paraphrased the lines that I have taken from the poem, and you are finding the exact line from the poem. I hope you are enjoying doing this activity. Next sentence is, he is unhappy because there is no sun. Page 34. Yes, you have been able to find it. It was easy. The rebel regrets the absence of sun. The rebel regrets the absence of sun. Okay, shall I read the next sentence for you? He is noisy on purpose. Again, go back to page 33. When the whole class is silent, they are taking the lesson. The rebel creates a disturbance. Have you done it? I am sure you must have done it. So, now you understand that by using opposites, the poet has created the context of a rebel. What others do, rebel does not do. Now I am going to ask you a few comprehension questions. Pay attention. I'll repeat the question. What does the rebel wear when everyone wears their uniform? You will find the answer on page 33. When everyone What does the rebel wear when everyone wears their uniform? The rebel wears fantastic clothes. Fantastic clothes means formal dress. Next question. What does the rebel need when everyone is praising the sun? It's bright sun outside. Everyone is praising and enjoying the sunlight. What does the rebel want? Page 34. Yes, you have found it. The rebel wants the rain. Next question. What does the rebel do when everyone agrees? When everyone agrees, what does the rebel do? Read out these lines. When everybody says, yes, please, the rebel says, no, thank you. When everybody says, no, thank you, the rebel says, yes, please. So he disagrees. When does a rebel create disturbance? Page 33. Yes, you have been able to find it. When does a rebel create disturbance? When everybody is silent and they are busy doing their lesson. So the poem is clear to you? Now I am going to ask you a question with four choices. Right? You have to tell me which is the right answer and why. I will read it out to you. What do you think the rebel doesn't like? The first, opposing the authority. Are we talking here about authority? No, we are not. We are talking about the nature of a person. Okay? The rebel doesn't like going with the flow. This seems right. He doesn't like to go with the flow. He or she will do the opposite of what others are doing. The rebel doesn't like taking lessons in a classroom. Yes, this is also not correct. The rebel doesn't like taking advice of any person. This also does not fit in the context. So when you get four choices, you have to connect each choice with the main question. You will be able to answer it better. I have another activity for you. Now here you can fill in the blank with any word from your context. Right? We are now going beyond the poem. Fill in the blanks. I will read the first part of the sentence and you can fill the second part with anything that you feel like, but it should go as the opposite word. I hope this is clear to you. The first one, when everyone wants to celebrate, the rebel, this is not from the poem. You can give any word which is opposite to the word celebrate. When everyone wants to celebrate, the rebel wants to stay at home. The rebel wants to sleep. Anything you can fill in that you want to fill, but that should be opposite to the word celebrate. I hope it is clear to you. The second sentence. When everyone wears jeans and t-shirt, the rebel wears dash. Now, jeans and t-shirt, they are casual dress, rough wear. You got the point? The rebel wears formal clothes. Third one. When others want to go to sleep, the rebel wants to read a book, stay awake. Anything you can fill in. When other wants a holiday, do you want a holiday? When others want a holiday, the rebel wants to go to school. Now you can fill in the blanks with the opposite words to complete the sentence. Now we come back to the last two lines of the poem. The poet says, why is it good to have rebels? You see, sometimes we have to provide people with different perspectives. So that doesn't mean that we are rebels. We are sharing a different point of view. So it is important to share your point of view, your idea, so that we learn from each other. So we should not call it a rebel. We should say that the person is having a different viewpoint. But the next part is, why is it not good to be a rebel oneself? Should we be rebels in real life? I don't think so. You see, if we oppose at every point, we will end up losing friends. If our friends are telling us, let's play, and you say that I want to read a book, if it happens every day that, you know, you will be alone. Sometimes it is okay, but not always. Secondly, discipline is an important thing in life. We should follow some discipline. So would you like to be a rebel? If yes, give reasons. I don't think so you would like to be a rebel. But yes, you can give your point of view. You can share your ideas that why at this point you want to do this. But not always. You cannot oppose a particular thing as a habit. So therefore, it is not a good thing. Discipline is a great value that we must develop among ourselves. Now, lot of opposites have been used in this poem. Let us now have fun with words. Opposites are also known as antonyms. There are a few words that I have picked up from the poem. Go back to your poem, page 33 and 34, and find out their opposites or antonyms. Long. Have you found out the word? Yes, it is short. Grow. The rebel wants to grow, or others are growing their hair. The rebel wants to cut. Quietness, disturbance. Sober. When others are wearing sober clothes, the rebel wears fantastic clothes. Lost, found. So these are some of the antonyms. Can you find more antonyms from the poem? I have given you a few examples. You find more antonyms. And if you want to learn more about antonyms, you can refer to a thesaurus. You will find examples of synonyms and antonyms in a thesaurus. Now I want you to write a poem. Use the same technique like using opposites. Instead of the word rebel. Now rebel sounds as if somebody is really opposite, doesn't want to listen. But my friend, if we write the word my friend, then it becomes little soft. I have written a few lines and I'll share those lines with you. Then you can continue writing. When everybody has short hair, my friend lets her hair grow long. When everybody has long hair, my friend cuts her hair short. When everybody talks during the lesson, my friend doesn't say a word. So you are generally talking about your friend. And have you noticed that instead of his, I have used the word her now? You can also recreate the poem by using the name of your friend. Instead of writing the words, my friend, you can write the name of your friend. And see, the context has changed. Now you are talking in the context of your friend. It doesn't seem that your friend is opposing everything. Now, can you write the poem? Either using the word my friend, or you can write the name of your friend. There are a few more antonyms that I have listed so that you are able to write the poem on your own. You don't have to use the words that have been given in the poem itself. So the words are dark, light. When I wear dark clothes, my friend wants to wear light clothes, light colored clothes. Similarly, thirsty, hungry. Full, empty. Noisy, quiet. Difficult, easy. Wide, narrow. Heavy, light. So there are a few antonyms I have shared with you. You can write the poem now. I'm sure you will be able to write. But then, let's go beyond the text. The poet has written the poem using the word the rebel. What are the antonyms of the rebel? The antonyms of rebel are obedient, loyal, compliant, loyalist, surrender. There is a long list. You can add to the list when you refer to a thesaurus. I want you to write a poem using the antonym of the word the rebel. You can choose the word obedient. You can choose the word comply and then write a poem. I hope you enjoyed the poem, The Rebel. With this, we have come to the end of this session. Thank you for being with us. Thank you so much for being with us. Happy learning. Wish you all the best.
So friends, you were just listening to the series Dhwani Shala. Production assistants, Meenakshi Kukreti, Tanu Gupta and Jagbandhu Jana. Recorded by Shanu Muksim and Vikas Sangwan. Produced by Vandana Arimardhan. This series was brought to you by CIET NCERT, New Delhi, India.
Thank you.